All right, on the play again. Oh, geez, what does this hand do? I think I'm actually gonna play a turn one Dark Tutelage. No, I can't. I don't have Mox Diamond. Mox Diamond doesn't, and Pluto Delta did not make two mana. All right, well, I think I'm actually just gonna play a turn one land tax then with. So, Mox Diamond, discard a land, land tax, Chromox Exile, Rest in Peace. The downside being. The upside being I can Enlightened Tutor. And then I'll have three mana next turn to play Skorok and use Skorok. The downside is that I don't get to have Rest in Peace in my hand still, which means if I'm playing against a deck that Rest in Peace hurts, I could be in trouble. Alright, my opponent kept his will. I'll start with the Mox Diamond. Let's see what my opponent does. Opponent said he was dishing out dinner. I was curious if it's a good dinner. I mean, that's a pretty logical question. Alright, Mox Diamond into land tax. And, alright. Spaghetti with Italian sausage. Yeah, can't go too wrong. Alright, let's, yeah. I'll take the gamble here. Yes, exile, rest in peace, and pass the turn. This is quite the hand. And this lets also me also Enlightened Tutor for a 3-drop if I need a 3-drop for another reason, so. Who knows what I'm playing against. Hopefully it's not Reanimator, because then losing out on the rest in peace kind of sucks, but it looks like Merfolk or Goblins. One of the tribal decks. Construct. What's going on here? Well, regardless of what's going on here, I'm getting a Skorak. Oh, but that was incredibly stupid. All right. I guess it's not terrible. I should, because of the way that this works, I can't actually land tax this turn. I have to just play the Skorak. So I guess I should have just passed land taxed. Upkeep Enlightened Tutor. So yeah, that even playing the Mox and Rest in Peace didn't make sense. So I'm sure whoever, as people were watching and figured this out before me, the whole time they're like, God, don't do that, don't do that, that's so stupid. So alright, Metalworker. Alright, Metalworker is fairly annoying. Let's get some action here. I guess these are good. Draw. Counterbalance is good. Alright, let's play a counterbalance. Obviously, I've got a big shot of not being able to counter some of the things my opponent's playing, but this Dark Tutelage actually could come in handy and counter a 3-drop. So what did I lose last turn? I basically missed out on getting to land tax once and getting to play lands. A pretty big hit. I mean, I'm in still a pretty good spot, depending on what comes out this turn, but I certainly could have played those last two turns better. Again, I should have just played land tax, said go, untap taxed, or untap taxed after tax resolves during my upkeep still, Enlightened Tutor, land Mox, Skorak. So I'd end up with an extra land in play and an extra two lands or three lands in hand. So, normally a big swing, but I'm actually going to be drawing a million cards here. So, all right, Lodestone Golem, Lodestone Golem. Steel Hellkite, Blightsteel Colossus. Jeez, all right, this is not good for me. I was hoping any threes would happen. So 11 mana. So what do you cast for 11 mana? A Lodestone Golem and a Steel Hellkite, I suppose. Wow, my opponent is going deep. All right, let's. I suppose I'm drawing. Probably gonna want to draw to so 12 mana. So I could just be playing the Blightsteel Colossus, Lodestone Golem. I'll just try to counter it. All right, land tax does not counter it. And Steel Hellkite. Well, that certainly doesn't get countered. Wow. Yeah, I'm definitely losing now. Why did my opponent have to play a land to kill City of Traders? What was the advantage of that? I don't know, so. Alright, well, end of turn, let's Skorak for the full amount here. And put cards on top, doesn't matter what order. Draw, draw. Probably still die here, since, there aren't very many things that get me out of Steel Hellkite just crunching me and destroy each non-land. So probably two. And I can't even really find a detention sphere. Well, let's just Skorak for the full amount. I guess I could find a Mox and detention sphere. Not quite. So I take, yeah, I'm actually just going to die here, so let's just put these back, because I think sometimes when you're looking at revealed cards and you can see it, it shows your opponent them, which is weird. So am I dead here? Yeah, my opponent actually probably just killed the Moxes, so. Alright, Metalworker, interesting. Paladin does not stop that. Jace is generally good against those decks. Energy Flux certainly is. Porphyry Nodes is a decent, but not great. Certainly want Seal of Cleansing, and do not want Aura Fracture or Spiritual Focus. So I don't want Rest in Peace. Moat. Moat seems okay. Abyss is certainly not good. Non-Artifact. Bam. Abyss out. Pie the Noodle, I think, out. I don't think... Looks like Spell Pierce is not going to be good here. Back to Basics actually seems okay. Do I want four Porphyry Nodes? Probably not. I do want Entreats. Mizing a nice Entreat seems like it could be pretty good. Is Dark Tutelage better or worse than Porphyry Nodes? Being in my upkeep. So they play Metalworker, I play Porphyry Nodes. Yeah, actually, I'll put in Porphyry Nodes and take out Dark Tutelage. Alright, so no black spells once again. Good thing to know.